stuff. I'm actually curious to see the clothes. Okay, oh, this was the shoe that... This was the shoe that people were going absolutely bonkers about. The ones that are like super ripped. I think they do sell the distressed version here, but this is kind of like the classic. So they got that. The Rhino Derbies. These are crazy. And then we have brand new colors of the Defenders. I don't really look into Balenciaga clothes like that. There's New York stuff. They had like a pair of like flared pants that I really liked. I think it's this. Nah, these are like the super baggy pants. See the Adidas. Like, if I'm gonna buy a Gucci Adidas, I'm gonna probably go like really, 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 really crazy. You got the bags. I just don't. It looks so gaudy to me. This is cool.
The little pouch.
This is cool. But this one is too gaudy. Oh, they got the green ones too. I'm not gonna lie.
Those are nice.
These are sick. Yeah, nah. It's like a nice velvet. Like, I'm not saying that the price is justifiable, but. And then they got the maroon one. Maroon ones too are sick. Oh, it feels so soft, dude. Yeah. But for the money, if someone were to tell me like, hey, you got X amount and you can buy one of them. You know already I'm coming. Oh yeah, I'm going for this. I don't even care. Yeah, hell nah. But I don't see the blue ones. I think the blue ones are actually sold out.
Brown, so not dope. Spot.
I see the
Orée. Oh, it's,
thank you, thank you. I see the Sade shirt.
Yep. Designed this myself actually.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh.
Oh, stuff.
Yo, but wait, you have a brand or something?
So I do like side stuff. But it's like a personal brand. It's not like
okay. Do you sell anything or just for you?
Yeah, well, mine. I've been selling this. So I have this one. I have an Usher one.
Okay, bet,
like,
bet.
I try to do this where it looks actually vintage.
Dude, nah. Like, but I've seen so many vintage t-shirts, and I legitimately thought this was like a real vintage shirt. Just, yeah, nah, you killed that. Like, you killed that.
It's crazy because this is like, I try to do it cheap as I can. This is like direct to garment, but
okay.
The actual graphic has like the crackles in it, so when you print
yeah,
it, it looks
nah.
Like it's smart.
Is there anything in the back? And then, come on, kiss of life.
That's
fine. Okay, no, you're gonna have to. You're gonna have to link the brand.
I got you. So,
yeah.
Pixel.co.
Okay.
That's the website. trying to drop more stuff this summer coming soon. So.
Are these available to buy?
These are actually sold out.
Damn.
I have some other ones there.
Yo, because I want this, bro.
I might actually restock this one.
Dude, it's beautiful. And then
so
we got the shorts.
These are actually just like kid lounge shorts.
And then we got the AOV. Nice.
We got curves. I can do an outfit, and I was like, this is how I feel today.
Nice.
It's about at my dinner emphasis. This is my favorite shoes, the loudest. There's my little feather shirt.
Is the chain heavy?
Not really. They just make a lot of noise when you walk.
Really? Okay.
Yeah,
we can't hear anything because it's
yeah,
so much
cause there's music, but like, when it's like in silence, you can hear the shoes.
Nice. All right. Well, thank you for being on the channel.
Yeah.
We out here. Cool. Yeah. NERD one is fire. What is this? Yeah, no, these are cool. I even like the little chair thingy.
Oh, that one?
Yeah.
Digital fashion with physical items. So you see here we have a hoodie, right? But we added an NFC chip in all of our hoodies. So if you tap that link here, it'll
damn,
take you to
okay.
the NFT listing, right? So everybody who has a physical item gets an NFT along with it.
Nice.
So yeah, that's
wait,
what
we're so wait, when you buy this, do you get to have it or like you can pick?
You got both, yeah, both.
Oh, you got both, okay,
so
got you, got you.
When we ask our customers to like pay, we ask them for their ETH address too. We send it to them.
That's okay, okay.
This was the event.
All right, that's the event. So wait, where did you guys do this event, in NY?
Yeah, in Brooklyn.
In Brooklyn, all right, bet.
That's a little bit of what it looked like.
You got the VR.
Yep.
Damn, all right.
And then last but not least, we got the Instagram filter, so whenever you walk into the shop, you'll see a product list of everything that we have for sale.
Gotcha.
On top of the QR code, you go ahead and scan that.
Man, come on, man. Come on, bro. What is this? And then you can move it.
Exactly.
Wow. Okay.
Our next event is gonna be in August.
Okay.
August, July, around that time.
Yeah.
Tribe Market NYC on
okay.
Instagram. My Instagram is Crystal Mikhail. And
Instagram.
Akil X Cooper on Instagram. _Farrell on Instagram.
Alright. Well, bro, this is sick, man. You guys are doing great. I'm definitely going to pull up to the pop-up whenever y'all
for sure,
do it.
For sure.
We're going to bring more people in.
For sure, man.
See, this is sick. Yeah. Nah, this is different.
Yeah.
You have the whole car. You did that. Come on, bro. What's going on, guys? Right here we have a pre-production sample that I wish to show you guys. This is going to be the Infantry Derby. It is a part of the Fall Winter 2022 lineup. And if you guys are tuned into my Instagram, I did post the teaser photos. So we have been working on this specific model for a couple of months now. Close to a year, which is essentially a updated version, the Derby with the toe caps. So, it is in the plastic, and here we go. This is a fully smooth out leather calfskin once again. This one is a very thick cut of calfskin. And as you guys can see, it has pretty much like a dress shoe type of aesthetic versus the tumbled leather of the previous models. I do prefer the tumbled leather, but this one gives it a very kind of like formal look to your Derby, which I kind of like. And yeah, so just black on black, once again, Vibram. One detail that I'm not sure if you can kind of see the comparison, outsole sticks out a little bit more. Versus this one that kind of is just pretty close to the actual stitching. It's a design choice and I actually really like it. So kind of like the shoe itself looks like it's protruding a little bit more outwards versus the original models. Just smooth calfskin of the Derbies. So really cool. Just wanted to show it to you guys. Here we go.
Department here at Sotheby's and fine jewels and magnificent jewels.
Beautiful.
Here at the Luxe Week. I'm not a pro with jewelry, but about 100 pair of diamonds.
I know.
We definitely have to get this.
Oh my goodness.
It's so epic.
And then, so we're going to buy this after this video.
Yeah,
this is going to be purchased.
Like a small $10 million, you
wow.
know.
Oh, you said $10
million? Oh yeah, $10 million. Just I think that's like where it might start.
Oh,
I'm not
my
positive.
Goodness.
I know.
Oh wow, you gotta wear the gloves to wear the
VIP access.
Oh my goodness.
Our 40 for 40 Air Force One collection.
Oh my.
Celebrating the 40th anniversary of the Air Force One.
Okay.
Nike's arguably most iconic silhouette, I would say.
Okay.
I don't know the sneakers as well as Jillian, if you want to tell like the story.
Are you you're a sneakerhead like that?
Oh yeah.
Are we? Okay.
Yeah.
Oh my god, you're gonna like test me now? And I think, I'm
well, this is going up, so when people, when you give like wrong facts, they're gonna come for you, you know what I'm saying? They're gonna be like, this shoe came out in 97, not 92.
Okay, okay. Let's do it this way then.
Yes.
What's your deal? How do you feel about the Air Force One? Do you have a favorite pair?
Oh, yeah, well, Air Force One is like a New York City classic.
What's
it mean
to you? Yes.
You know, growing up is like, this was. When you had Air Force One, you were quote unquote legit.
Yeah.
Our parents didn't have money, so they bought the bootleg Air Force One with the jump man, but not the same jump.
Yeah.
Well, kind of weird ass jump. So when I got older, I was like, okay, Air Force One, white on whites, obviously. It's like,
yeah,
you know,
the crispy whites.
All the kids, it was the same thing. Air Force One was a thing.
Yeah.
So yeah, Air Force One Jordans and things like that. Basketball shoes, because I played basketball growing up.
Yeah.
So yeah.
Did you wear Air Force Ones to play basketball?
No.
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 Right.
No. These are like the shoes you wear like outside court.
Yeah, totally.
Yeah, just chilling with your friends, you know, kind of pick up game.
Nobody really wore them.
Yeah, yeah. They're not. I don't know if they're actually good for basketball.
Well, that's what they were created for.
Yeah.
Well, the highest with the Angels drop.
Yeah.
Right. Right. Yeah. But for these ones, it's mostly like a style thing.
Completely.
And then when you implement these kind of colors and these crazy prints, then.
Yeah.
That's when the kind of style fashion aspect kind of flows into it.
Yeah.
And then, you know, as a kid, listen to rap music, Nelly, mm-hmm. Air Force One.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah, just my brain was like,
yeah,
you know,
huge. You grew up in your way.
Yeah, white on whites, black on blacks. That was like the only colors that we've seen like in stores and stuff.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I think later on they started making like the crazy, you know, like the Jeff Staple and stuff.
Yeah.
Afterwards, but I think I was too young to even know about that.
Yeah, Teron, who's the head of our department.
Yeah,
I'm standing on the subway and like literally like 5 or 6 people around me. Like I'm standing in there
with
my sneakers, and every person around me is in.
Yeah.
Either one was black on black, and then everyone else was white on
white. Yeah, white on white.
Like literally, and that was like
white
last
on white.
Year.
Yeah.
So it's so funny to think about how you like grew up in this shoe. It's never like some maybe it like kind of is a little cyclical, but like literally never goes out of
style. It never, yeah.
40 years.
You can wear it with like trousers.
Exactly.
You know, you can wear it with like jogging pants, whatever, yeah. But like, and it still kind of looks yeah. tasteful. All right, so let's just pause real quick. While I'm editing this video, I notice on the corner the gentleman looking at sneakers is Ari. So if you guys don't know, the Ari Menthol like is essentially the grandfather of bootleg sneakers. And he was at the same event. I wish I was like aware that it was him. I was just like so busy into the conversation that I didn't notice he was standing right next to me. So that's kind of crazy. But yeah, if you guys don't know, I'll put a photo of Ari and the shoes. Get back to the video.
Sale is about like truly like the 40 years of it and the
yeah,
history of it.
Right.
And exactly what you're talking about. Like, and so I was saying, like, did you actually wear them for basketball? Because like they were engineered originally to be
right,
a basketball
right.
sneaker.
I don't think I've seen anybody wear them for basketball, to be honest.
Like,
never,
did.
Yeah.
And that's
yeah.
why they tried to cancel it, right?
Right,
and
right.
Then, so yeah, so you know, I'm sure you're familiar with the story, but we just were telling the story of
this is cool.
How incredibly important it was in yeah riding right along and part of the birth of like hip hop culture
right
all
right.
through the '80s, the music, the album covers, Dapper Dan, you know, changing them around
yeah,
and all
right,
the album covers
right,
and the poets.
Right,
so anyway, so yeah, we talk about like, you know, obviously let's like, touch on some of the music and then it's New York City sneaker. Okay, we are representing with Quest Love in Philly.
Yeah, yeah.
Obviously the Shape Records. The other thing too. That we have over here, this is like our Nike area.
Yes.
We're paying some respects to, we've got, you know, Chris Halls.
Yes, yes. Oh my
we
goodness.
Have the Eakins.
These are like old shoes that I would see as a kid online.
So fun.
Yes,
because
oh my goodness.
Because we give these like general tourists to people who don't even really know like what the Air Force
right,
is.
Right, right, right.
Once you start to like really get into it with people who know, I'm like,
yeah.
here's the Michael Lau. Like I haven't gotten to talk about this on any of the tours I'm doing because nobody knows. Is
and the fact and the
he,
fact that you
but
get
this is probably one of the coolest shoes we have in the collection.
Incredible.
Like look at the dongs, like look at the scratched up numbers, like the scratch inside. And then do you see over here it's got 25 to celebrate the 25th anniversary.
Look what we got.
Okay. I love this pair. And we ship these in from Hong Kong.
Wow. So all of these shoes here, are these from like private collectors? Or how does that work?
Yeah, privates.
Okay.
Some dealers too.
Okay.
Yeah, definitely.
Got you. All right, we got an up close and personal right there. Damn. Wow.
I just think these are so
yeah.
beautiful. Like,
and even
you think
the
about,
inside
like, white
too.
On whites, like
yeah.
this, the quilting.
Incredible.
But the numbers. So Eric was telling me he thinks this is like one of like his lucky number.
Right.
And then I love that you've got these scratched out tally marks. And then like check out the sock.
Wow. Just the sock liner, everything.
Yeah, the sock
beautiful.
Liner insoles. Thread is edible. I learned that like in the past 24 hours. You can actually eat, it's like made of rice paper. And the whole candy.
So are we gonna try it or what?
Eat the whole thing.
You take one piece, I take one piece?
Oh, cool. I hear they don't taste it.
It doesn't, it looks pretty old and like,
well,
it looks pretty
candy.
Nasty.
Goodness. Right.
I remember like Fat Joe had a pair that kind of looked like this.
Yeah, the Luxes probably.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, yeah, the 07 Luxes.
It's like...
They made them in the Sikhs, in the Python.
Yeah.
They did an alligator one.
Man.
But they're not as gorgeous as these. These are like ridiculous.
And then you got the whole...
24 karat here, the aglets and the Dubrays.
Wow.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Gorgeous, right? Really gorgeous.
And...
So you know how in Lunar New Year culture, this is where you would put like all the candies for the kids, right? Usually this is like their candy box. And so instead of that, look at how they did all of the laces.
Wow.
All Terror Squads.
All Terror Squad.
Of course.
Wow.
Talk about the history without him.
And then you got the custom Terror Squad on the heel.
Uh-huh.
You know, and even on the sock liner too.
Yeah.
Yeah. Wow, look at that. Terror Squad. Interesting. Look at that.
You would think, but
I have the Complex Cons, the white ones. Yeah, I bought it off a kid that got them on Complex Con. He did like a nice little trade and.
That's the one we're missing.
Yeah.
You should sell it with us.
Oh, mine's are beat. Mine's are beat. Sadly.
See, you're someone you can wear up.
Yes.
That's how I am too.
I don't know.
People buy them and don't buy them. I can't.
I have a couple of shoes that like I will not touch. Like I have a couple of 85 Jordan 1s that I'm like the box.
Yeah.
I'll wear them like to somebody's wedding or something.
Yeah.
I'll be that guy.
Yeah.
But me just going on a train, going to Uniqlo, no. That's not gonna happen. Yes.
I went into the Goop store down Goop store.
Yes.
Okay, when it was down, I think that they reopened it. It was like before COVID.
Yeah.
It was down on Bond Street is where they had it.
Yeah.
And it was raining and I walk in there and I'm wearing my Air Max 97 OGs.
Wow.
And I would like wear them all around like in the rain, like whatever.
Just like, just everyday type of thing, you're right.
Uh-huh. And I walk into the store and the security guard, he's there, he sees me, I'm like walking around, like I'm like, you know, I was like there to get something. I walk out and he goes, OGs in the rain?
Right.
And I
was like,
But like the comments I get when I wear cool sneakers are the best.
Yeah, it hurts,
I was like, they're so comfortable, like I love them.
It's like my everyday shoes.
They're my rain shoes. He was like,
I don't really put the value. Like, when you buy something, you know, you gotta use it to, you know, its fullest extent. You know what I'm saying? Like, I have like Yeezy 2s, like the Solars, and I would just wear that to go out. People are like, you wearing this now? Like, you know? But I'm like, to me, it's like I bought this. I have to use it for its, you know, for its. To use it.
Yeah.
But yeah, some sneakerheads are like, you're a little different, but
I know.
It's okay.
So there's like the separation there. It's like the ones who wear them.
I have friends who have just like, you know, those clear boxes and it just goes all the way to the roof and they can tell you every little detail.
Yeah.
But then when they go out they're wearing like just a plain pair of Air Maxes.
Right.
But they have like some of the greatest shoes at home.
Yeah.
The MoMAs.
The MoMAs, the MCAs, the ICAs. So all beautiful color, right?
Even this one. This one is
I
neat.
Love this.
This is neat.
And I love the color of his signature. So these are obviously signed by him. But also what's so special about this is we've got also the tag box, we've got, you know, the signed box too.
Wow.
And then also he signed them to one of his like idols growing up.
Oh, Bobito. We know Bobito Garcia. Yes.
Right.
We
of
know.
Course, Bobito Garcia.
Yes.
So these are his a pair that Virgil gave him.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm sure then you know all about this.
Yes.
Of course, how he grew up going to his shows.
Yes.
And watching him spin, right? And then it gets to like, I just love those stories.
It's like.
And then
you're...
this is like a moment marked where he's giving the shoe now to your
idol, you know?
Yeah. Isn't that so cool?
It's, you know, obviously sad that Virgil's not here to, you know, but I'm sure a lot of people like myself, we look up to Virgil like,
oh my God.
Pretty much everything he's done for like, just fashion in general is incredible.
Yeah.
Incredible. And for like, these short amount of time that he's been here and did all that is like to me it's incredible.
It's incredible.
Like it's not even human sometimes. You're like you did Louis, you did Off-White, the Nike stuff, countless projects. Incredible. I feel like he shook up the whole fashion spectrum in terms of like the integration of streetwear. It's so normalized now, but like a couple years ago having like denim or you know these kind of sneakers for like a Dior show or whatever, like it's just like you know,
like, I mean, even like when you think about how some shows, maybe it was just before COVID.
Okay.
COVID got like made everything kind of weird, but they started showing denim in the couture shows.
Yeah.
Like they were actually using denim for couture.
Yeah.
Like that's Virgil.
That's
to
the
me,
thing.
Like
yeah.
That's it.
Yeah.
Right?
That.
Like, would that have happened, like, without him? Like,
even,
I don't think,
I
don't know.
Or even just, like, sweats, like, something like sweats.
Yeah.
Putting it in a big show like that. You know, sweats is seen as, like, you don't leave your house with sweats.
Yeah.
Yet alone putting it in a whole Louis show.
Yeah.
So just kind of like that blend of not separating anything anymore.
Yeah.
Is and that's doing it in such a tasteful way at that is incredible.
Amazing.
Wow.
So, completely.
These ones. I remember seeing
before he passed.
Right.
That he wanted to obviously doing a Louis Vuitton Air Force One.
Right, no, absolutely.
And building off like what he's done with just in sneaker culture in general. And so he had wanted to auction something off of his foundation.
Right.
And so Louis Vuitton saw through all of his visions, right? Yeah. Like through the end. Just a beautiful.
Amazing. Yeah, no, it's
and,
beautiful.
And you know, they have a whole show in Greenpoint.
Yes. Yeah, we went to visit. Yeah, it's.
I mean, that treehouse.
Incredible. House. Yeah.
Oh my God. So cool. And all of those speakers, like, so anyway, just seeing through all of his vision, like, we were the first to offer it to the world.
Yeah,
right?
I've seen it,
friends and family, but in that same week, right, we're then opening up our auction, just the 200 of them. And for the sale, we were fortunate enough to have a buyer who was, you know, was willing to.
Well, he was like from overseas, right? The buyer that bought that ultimately bought the shoe?
Well, there was 200 of them.
Yeah, okay. But the one, because I know it was like, there was like one notable video of a guy coming.
Who knows? I'm not sure exactly specifically what you're talking about.
Right.
Because there was, like, I think, like a few videos. I wonder.
Yeah. There was like one Asian dude that pulled up in like a limo or some shit.
Oh.
And then he came with a personal driver and he got to sign like some documents.
I think I know who.
And I was like, okay.
There were like a few people. There was somebody who brought an entire movie crew.
Oh,
so, like,
that's crazy.
There was like multiple people who did that. So wait, can I tell you the best part of what we did in Holland? Every pair that shipped.
Yeah.
So you could like shoot your video and come in and do all that. It's amazing.
Right.
But if they had chosen to have them shipped, every one of them was personally hand delivered in an armored truck.
Wow.
Stop.
Okay, yeah, yeah. I was thinking of
Right.
Yeah.
It's like literally like the same company that delivers diamonds. You know, that delivers like all
like,
the most valuable objects in the world, which is one of.
Dude, I would answer the door in a full suit. Just be like, hey, yes, I was waiting for you. Or I would either do that or like go the total opposite and like just be in my underwear. I'd be like, yo, give me the shoe, man. I already spent like a lot. Just give me the damn shoe. Got the Michael Jackson gloves.
You know what? We should get a pair of that for when we do these.
Yeah, nice pair of glittery gloves. Just to add to the, you know, to everything. Oh my goodness.
So yeah, look at this. The monogram, which is they made like nice and tiny, but then they also included.
Wow.
Large.
That's incredible.
So you'll see, I love this detail of the lisette instead of, you know, he always has the shoelaces.
Yeah, yeah. Nice
of course,
French.
Modeling after his off-white. You know what I mean? One of my also absolute favorite details, which you can't miss. Can you see it?
Yes, beautiful.
I love that. I love the logos. And obviously, Orin Jacques the Nike box.
Yes.
Right?
Wow.
Oh, she's an Uli. And they are the most beautifully crafted sneakers.
Oh, these. Oh, wow.
So the shoes are out already, but.
So when you get the shoe from, let's say, like, when you order it and somebody receives it, is there, like, somebody who unboxes it for you, or you just get the shoe and then that's it?
You, when we deliver the shoe, it's yours and you can do whatever you want with it.
Okay, gotcha.
The armored truck and the armored men, they don't come inside.
Oh, okay, I thought they were going to sit down, you know, have a little cocktail.
Once
and
they hand them off.
It's like, it's all you.
So it's all, like, the Colton tour.
Oh, man.
Beautiful.
Just the box and the bag itself, like, regardless of the shoes, is already something, you know?
Yeah,
okay, I see. Yes, yes. Wow.
Yeah.
This is impressive. This is
beautiful.
One of the coolest things I've seen.
Did you get this? My favorite detail? Are you sure?
Yeah, we gotta get this three times.
You can't get it.
Three times for you. Three times for you.
Did you see it? Do you want to see it again?
Okay, one more time. Oh, well, we're doing everything. I'm like.
Are they tingling? My hands tingled the first time I heard
it. Oh, man, okay. All right, we got the Michael Jackson gloves.
I don't
know. Yeah, like silky, nice little silky
so
gloves.
Fancy.
Yeah.
I really like the idea. I know.
It's like you guys have the $2 gloves with the how much $1,000 shoe.
Okay.
All right, guys.
Hold it.
Stretch it.
I'll spot you.
All right.
In case your hands go numb.
Yes. All right. Ready. Do I go like this or do I like that? Okay. Cool. Wow. So it's like the mix of the classic Louis monogram. There's the, is this the Damier print? Damier print.
and just like this like cool beige piping around the entire shoe. And then it almost kind of has like a stacked effect. Both, we could do both?
Sure, yes. For you?
For me, yeah, we're gonna do both for me.
For you.
What size is this?
They're a size in
that. Oh, too small already.
Oh. This is on my foot. Wow. Yeah, I'm touching these, guys. I'm touching these. These are crazy.
You got gloves on.
Yeah, I got the gloves
on,
too.
Can I take a picture of it?
Yeah, oh, yeah. Course. You want me in the phone?
Of course I do. Oh, you're so pretty. You don't even have to try. Flirt with the camera a little bit. Come on.
Shoulder out.
Natural. Shoulder.
Have you done this before?
It's beautiful.
It's incredible.
Adorable.
How much sweat?
I know.
You're
I know.
You're sweating.
I know.
Oh, my God. Okay. Yeah, we're done.
Really got to put them down before I start.
No reserve. Excuse me. So we open bidding at $1.
$1.
And then
obviously that went for $1. I know. Like, where are they? I keep it. Is it past 110? Is it past 110? Is it past 110? Yeah. Well, like, there's that, but like even besides this, there's like all the Air Forces stuff that I've never seen or think I was gonna see in the flesh. Um, you guys have been so great. Like, the tour, oh my gosh, we're so happy to have you. I will be linking the Sotheby's sneakers Instagram. Yes. Gotta get
at Sotheby's sneakers.
And then as well as just like Sotheby's as well. Thank you to everybody for the nice, you know, nice little tour. We did bags. No, we didn't do bags.
We didn't do bags.
But we did like no cool jewelry. We did obviously sneakers and
Let's go over five. Yeah, we got bags, we got watches. Yeah, quick. I know.
We need to
open the box.
I remember seeing this one in the show, and the guy was holding it like that, and you can kind of see the wings flapping a little bit, which is kind of cool. It was really neat.
As a way of Sotheby's professionals, it was a bargain. Let's say that. But no, we had done about $10 million in sales this time, so you know how much I love to spend. So very wonderfully censored in it.
Oh.
But that's the beauty about Cremant's leather is that it wears over time, but it's meant to look kind of a shabby chic in a way. Like Joanna Gong, where'd she go? But she would use it as a laundry hamper. That would be her dream.
Oh, man.
Yes, it's a workout.
It's a workout, yeah.
Are you going to the office for that?
I do, yeah. I've been sitting here for 3 days. I need a little break.
You're saving the
shoes.
The
it always starts with one and then goes.
Yeah, I feel like that's how it spills over. When you bought all the sneakers you can, then it's like, what else could I buy? Then watches.
Oh yeah.
But I feel like everybody starts with a Rolex, you know, just kind of like a regular Rolex.
Someone called me a basic bee though. I was like, I think it's like the best watch to have. It's a beater.
Yeah, exactly.
Like, you don't have to worry at all.
Man, somebody did that to you?
Yeah, but AP, I will say, is like, if that's your starter watch, then like,
you're a cool guy. Oh my goodness. I just find them too big, APs.
You should do it like that.
Yeah, no, just because the lighting is kind of, it's conflicting. Bunch of APs. Sotheby's.
That
crazy.
I recognize.
The rainbow Rolex.
I don't know if that's actually
the rainbow Rolex. It's so good, dude. It's like this, like the Dali painting, almost like the melting effect. This one has diamonds on it though. Ugh. But it's beautiful.